there is a difference between having a goalkeeper and having a defender in front of the goal. Think about if the ball, as the ball and the players converge on a goal, you naturally will end up with players standing in front of the goal. That's just the way it is. And that's the way it should be. You're taught to defend the goal. That's a different thing than planting a player in front of the goal while the game's still down way down here. Does that make sense? So if it's a hard, and we'll talk about this via email later in the season. It's the difference between, I call it, all players should be connected to the play. So if the ball is here and you're defending this goal down here, they all of your players, all the defenders, say the triangles, ooh, that's a terrible triangle, the triangles are defending that goal. All the triangles should be connected to the play. Does that mean standing on top of the ball? Of course not. I don't want that. That's bad. But they should be connected to the play. So there's probably going to be a player on the ball, and there's probably going to be another player kind of off the side a little bit. And if you want to have another player here to pick up the loose ball or to stop the breakaway, I'm okay with that. Because this player is about one pass, maybe two passes away from where the ball is. Does that make sense? He's connected to the play. At any given moment, he could either be on the ball or very close to the ball and about the next person to receive the ball. When I see kids hanging out back here, that player is not connected to the play. Now, some coaches will coach that, and we're trying to fix that. They shouldn't be coaching it because it's bad soccer. When I get them at U11, I have to break them of that habit. It's terrible soccer. Go watch an actual soccer match and see how often the ball is here and they have any defender standing inside their own 18. Never happens. Never. Why? Because it's bad soccer. You will lose every game if you play like that. Hey. They all need to be connected to the play. Now, some players will naturally gravitate back here. By nature, they're cautious people, and they don't want to give up a goal, so they're kind of hanging back a little bit. If that's the case for you, and that happening on your team, have that. That's a bad habit that we need to have that player break and work with that player to get them to break that habit. Step up, up you go. Come on, let's get connected to the play. Because when you have a player back here, you're only playing 3v4 here. Real tough to score when you're playing down a man, right? If you put two players back here, like I see some people doing, now you're playing 2v4. You're almost never going to score now. So have that player step up, get connected to the play. If you are coaching against the coach who is having that happen, look carefully and make a decision about, well, is that just happening? Or is the coach coaching that? If it's just happening, let it roll off your back. If the coach is coaching it, let it roll off your back. I can't fix Amy. If Amy wants to coach to win and play people in the back and have a de facto goalkeeper, I can't fix Amy. I'm only going to cause problems if I try and talk to Amy. Let it go. Be the better person.